Decades of research in the gene therapy field is paying off. In 2017, the very first gene therapy products were approved in the U.S., with more likely to be approved this year, and thousands more in clinical trials, including a trial for Rett syndrome. Sponsored by AveXis, a Novartis company, expected to get underway this year. So what exactly is gene therapy? It's the addition of new genes to a person's cells to replace faulty genes in an attempt to prevent, improve, or cure disease. Genes need a bit of help to get into cells. One way they get that help is through a virus. Now, think about what viruses normally do. They are really good at getting into our bodies and making us sick. They do that by injecting their genetic material into our cells. So scientists had the great idea of hijacking a virus to deliver genes into cells. But don't worry, they remove the parts that make us sick. The modified virus is called a vector. So how would this work in Rett syndrome? Well, we know that Rett is caused by mutations in a gene called MECP2, which creates a protein that is very important for brain function. So first, billions of copies of the MECP2 gene are manufactured in a lab. Then, the manufactured genes are packaged inside the vectors. In the upcoming clinical trial, a person with Rett will receive a single injection of gene therapy product called AVXS-201 into their cerebral spinal fluid. The vectors will then carry their precious cargo to the brain and deliver it into the nucleus of the cells. Once this is accomplished, the vector naturally disintegrates, and the new MECP2 genes go to work making the healthy and vital protein. Our hope is that individuals will improve dramatically. What symptoms will improve and by how much and in which individuals? These are questions that will remain unanswered until the clinical trial is undertaken. One thing we do know, if improvements do happen, they won't happen overnight. It will take time, intense therapies, and lots of hard work. RSRT started funding gene therapy experiments in 2010, and we've spent almost $7 million to date. Our first gene therapy consortium launched in 2014 and generated the data that led to AveXis's decision to pursue Rett. We're extremely hopeful, but we can't just sit idle while we wait for trial results, which is why we launched Gene Therapy Consortium 2.0 last year to start working on a second generation gene therapy product, just in case. The goals of Gene Therapy 2.0 are to maximize the number of brain cells the vector can penetrate, and also find ways to control the amount of protein the new healthy genes make. The more shots on goal, the better. Which is why we're also funding a number of other potentially curative approaches, including DNA editing, RNA editing, RNA transplicing, and MECP2 reactivation projects. Just look at what your donations are making possible. Together, we will leave no stone unturned on our roadmap to a cure. Thank you.